اللهم ارزقنا القناعة،
آمين.
اللهم حببنا في صلاة الجماعة،
آمين.
اللهم احشرنا يا ربنا مع النبي المصطفى صاحب الشفاعة.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. عباد الله، today is the 29th of Ramadan. If it pleases Allah, Ramadan would end today, and if it pleases Him, He would grant us one more day of Rahmah, in which case Ramadan would end tomorrow. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that 29 days ago I sat before you in this very studio, and you sat at home to watch me, that Allah has counted you and me among those to be here 29 days in Ramadan is a reason to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we Muslims, we have many reasons to thank Allah. First and foremost, that He has made us Muslims, for it is not by our own choosing that we are guided, except that Allah has counted us amongst those who are guided, and we thank Him. To thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is an act of worship in Islam, and indeed when it comes to showing gratitude, Allah leads by example Himself. When Allah says in Surah Al-Kahf, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم الحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب ولم يجعل له عوجا, that Allah saying He deserves our praise, He deserves our thanks, He deserves our gratitude. For what? For sending down the revelation, i.e. the Quran, through His prophet, Al-Rasul, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has guided us to this. In many places in the Quran, Allah talks about the importance of showing gratitude to Allah. For instance, in Surah An-Nahl, Allah says, وَمَا بِكُمْ مِنْ نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ, whatever has come your way by way of favor, Allah says, فَمِنَ اللَّهِ, it is from Allah. And we as Muslims, we acknowledge that it is by Allah that we are here 29 days in Ramadan. Allah says in Surah to Ibrahim, He says, أَنْ تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْسُوهَا, meaning if you make an effort to count the blessings of Allah on you, La tuhsuha, you would not be able to exhaust the blessings, the counting of the blessings of Allah on you. We thank Him for the many blessings, the first of which is that we are guided aright. And then Allah says in Surah Al-Baqarah, Fadhkuruni adhkurukum washkuruli wala takfuruni. Meaning that, remember me and I will remember you. Then show gratitude to me and then do not disbelieve in me. We remember Allah and we beseech Him to remember us. In Surah Al-A'raf, Allah says, Rahmati wasi'at kull shay'in. He says that His mercy, His rahmah, it transcends all things, i.e. believers, non-believers. They all enjoy the rahmah of Allah. And in Surah Ash-Shura, Allah says, Allahu latifum bi'ibadihi yarizuku man yasha'u wa huwa al-qawiyyul 'azim. That gracious is Allah to His servants. He blesses whom He wills, and is the one who has power that is incomparable. And in that famous surah, Allah says, La in shakaritum la azidannakum wa la in kafaritum in adhabi la shadid. That when you would thank me, my reaction to you thanking me would be that I will bless you even more. And then Allah says, but if you disobey me, then my punishment is severe. We beseech Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to not let us taste even the simplest of His punishments. Ibadallah, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Ramadan would be over, they would spend the next 6 months beseeching Allah to accept it from them. And then 6 months to the next Ramadan, they would be praying unto Allah to let them be amongst the witnesses to the next Ramadan. In this regard, in this segment today, we want to pray to Allah to accept all we have done and to preserve us till the next Ramadan. Allahumma ihdina fi man hadait wa afina fi man afait wa tawallana fi man tawallait wa barik lana fi ma a'tait وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت تباركت وتعاليت ولك الحمد يا الله على ما قضيت ولك الشكر على ما أنعمت به وأوليت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك نستغفرك اللهم من كل ذنب وخطيئة ونتوب إليك ونؤمن بك ونتوكل عليك أنت الغني ونحن الفقراء إليك أنت القوي ونحن الضعفاء إليك اللهم يا واصل المنقطعين أوصلنا إليك اللهم هب لنا منك عملا صالحا يقربنا إليك اللهم استرنا فوق الأرض وتحت الأرض ويوم الأرض عليك اللهم أحسن وقوفنا بين يديك اللهم لا تخزنا يوم الأرض عليك اللهم تقبل منا صلاتنا وتقبل منا صيامنا وتقبل منا قيامنا وتقبل منا ركوعنا وتقبل منا سجودنا وتقبل منا دعاءنا وتقبل منا توبتنا وتقبل منا عبادتنا. اللهم اجعلنا من اتقاه شهر رمضان. اللهم اجرنا من النار. اللهم اجرنا من خزي النار. اللهم ادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار برحمتك يا عزيز يا غفار. اللهم اجعلنا يا مولانا في شهرنا هذا وفي يومنا هذا وفي ليلتنا هذه من اتقائك من النار، واجعلنا من المقبول الى الفائزين برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. برحمتك يا الله يا رحمن يا الله يا رحيم يا الله يا رحيم يا الله يا مالك يا الله يا قدوس يا الله يا قدوس يا الله يا سلام يا الله يا مؤمن يا الله يا مؤمن يا الله يا مهيمن يا الله يا عزيز يا الله يا عزيز يا الله يا جبار يا الله يا متكبر يا الله. سبحانك عما يشركون. اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك وأغننا بفضلك عما سواك. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الهم والحزن ومن العجز والكسل ومن البخل والجبن وضلع الدين وغلبة الرجال. اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا، وأنت تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا. اللهم أحسن عاقبتنا في الأمور كلها، وأجرنا من خزي الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك، ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا بها جنتك، ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. ومتعنا بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا، واجعل الوارث منا، واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا، وانصرنا على من هدانا، ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا، ولا مبلغ علمنا، ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا. اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا هما إلا فرجته، ولا دينا إلا قضيته، ولا حاجة من أوائج الدنيا والآخرة إلا قضيتها يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا ورزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الجنون والجذام، نعوذ بك من الجنون والجذام والبرص وكورونا وسيء الأسقام. اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا ورزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا رضينا بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيا صبوح قدوس رب الملائكة والروح 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 ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا إننا سمعنا مناديا ينادي للإيمان أن آمنوا بربكم فآمنا ربنا أتمم لنا نورنا واغفر لنا إنك على كل شيء قدير ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين وجعلنا للمتقين إماما ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إسرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك نبنا وإليك المصير ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وقنا عذاب النار وقنا عذاب النار وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه الأخيار وسلم تسليما كثيرا سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين آمين يا الله we have called upon you with your beautiful names accept our dua accept our Ramadan accept our ibadat accept our tilawa Accept our Qiyamul Layl, accept our Tahajjud. Ya Allah, when your messengers got into trouble with you and they called upon you, you accepted their dua. When our father, Adam alayhi salatu wassalam, when he got into trouble with you, he called upon you and you responded to him. Rabbana dhulamna anfusana. وَإِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرِ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ With this statement, did you accept the supplication of Adam, alayhi salatu wassalam? Accept our supplication, Ya Allah. Prophet Nuh, alayhi salatu wassalam, when he got into trouble with you, he called upon you and you saved him. لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ Subhanaka inni kuntu min adh-dhalimin. With this statement, you brought him out of 3 layers of darkness in the ocean and you saved him. We have called upon you with your beautiful names that you have enjoined us to call upon you. Accept our dua, preserve us till the next Ramadan, and let us be in a position to remain in servitude to you. We seize this opportunity to thank our brothers and sisters who have been the financial power behind this program, without whom we couldn't be here 29 days in a row, possibly for one more day. Ya Allah, let your promise be fulfilled upon them. Replenish the sources from which they took these monies manifold, and then reward them in the best of manners that only you can reward. Our brothers who may not have put money down, but have been at the studio every day for 29, for 30 days, living their daily assignment, we beseech you, Allah, to count their being here as ibadat, and to count it on their scales of good deeds. Finally, our association, the Companion, and our sister association, the Criterion, we beseech you to let our organization grow from strength to strength to strength to strength. We call upon you for us to be able to bequeath this to our children, such that when we will be no more, our children will make the associations better than we may have done with our power. Bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
All Muslims have to do 5 things. Who knows what they are?
Shahada, Salah, Zakah.
A Companion Zakah Fund Committee is one of the major organ of the organization that is designed and put in place to basically be in charge of the assessment, the collection, as well as distribution of zakat. Collection from the people that are eligible to pay zakat, and then to administer the payment and disbursement of this zakat, you know, to all the people that qualify to, you know, basically receive zakat in line with the injunction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and as demonstrated by Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
You're welcome to the first Criterion College.
Here, you are assured of qualitative, quantitative, Islamic and general education.
The Quranic memorization program is world-class and competes favorably with any other. The recreational activities and psychomotor skills are well entrenched in our educational curriculum for the healthy development of your child. The First Criterion College affords you continuous reward when you bring your child to this great citadel of learning for a well-rounded and balanced education laced with morals.
The First Criterion College is located at 628 Oseni Alagbaje Street off Igbe Road, Ikorodu, Lagos.
For more information, visit our website at www.thefirstcriterioncollege.com or call 080-9056-7305.
Allahumma arzuqna al-qana'ah.